even after they were born again, he says, don't go anywhere, don't speak to anybody, don't do any miracles until you receive power from on high. And then they received the baptism of the Holy Spirit and spoke in tongues. Speaking in tongues is not the only thing that the baptism of the Holy Spirit does, but it's like something that every person who receives the baptism of the Holy Spirit can do. Speaking in tongues is kind of like the ignition switch that you turn it, and all of a sudden, the power of God just starts working. And when you turn the ignition switch on your car, all of a sudden that motor comes to life, and now it's capable of automatically receiving the Holy Spirit just because you got born again. So you need to receive both of those before you can start operating in what we've talked about here today. Is there anybody here that would say, I need one or both of those? Either you need to be born again and filled with the Holy Spirit, or you've already been born again, but you haven't ever been filled with the Holy Spirit and you don't speak in tongues. Is there anybody here like that? If that's you, I want you to raise your hand. I want to pray with you so that you can receive. Right. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus as your personal Savior. Again, there's a lot of people that think being a Christian is just acknowledging that God exists and trying to do the best you can, but that's not true Christianity. True Christianity is receiving salvation as a gift. You believe that Jesus died for your sins, and He said that if you would confess Him with your mouth and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you would be saved. You have, when you say that Jesus is your Lord, that's more than just acknowledging that He existed, but it's saying, I'm turning my life over to Him. I'm putting my trust in Him. You believe that? Awesome. If you pray that and believe it, then according to Scripture, you are born again. And the Bible also says that you are the temple of the Holy Spirit. God, when you get born again in the Spirit, He made you like a temple that He wants to fill with the Holy Spirit. That's God's will. So we don't have to beg with God to receive the Holy Spirit. Some people teach that receiving the Holy Spirit is very hard, and that you have to plead with God. It takes years.
It'll explain this and help you to understand. If you're ready, you just get to come here. The Holy Spirit's not going to take your mouth and make it talk. This is where I struggled for a long time, because I just wanted it to be pure Holy Spirit. It's not pure Holy Spirit. The Bible says you speak with tongues as the Spirit gives inspiration. The Holy Spirit doesn't speak in tongues. He inspires you. It's just like when I talk today, I believe that God spoke through me. But if I was just open to mind, you know what? Your parents knew what you were trying to say. And they were thrilled. And they understood. Your Heavenly Father's going to know what you're trying to do. And it may be kind of like baby talk, but as soon as you quit worrying about what it sounds like, it'll grow into a fluent language and it's powerful. Every person has some.
says that I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Lo, I'm with you always, even unto the end of the world. Where two or three are gathered together in my name,